Hi Aries, welcome to my channel. So in today's video we are going to check out your energies for middle of the month of July 2021 and we will see what are the guidance messages for you in the middle of July. Okay, so this is going to be a general reading. It may or may not resonate with all of you, so take what resonates and leave the rest. If this is not your story, do not try to make it yours. Okay. And I'll be looking at your past, present and future energies in this reading. So let's get started now for the middle month of July 2021 for my Aries. What is going on for my Aries? This is a Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus sign video. So if one sign does not resonate with you anywhere, you can check my other signs as well. Okay. All right. Aries, mid-month, July. Aries, mid-month, July. Past, present and future energies, please. Past, present and future. All right. So, the obstacle for you in the middle of the month is Eight of Swords. All right, so let's see. And what is the overall energy for you this mid-month is the Four of Wands. Okay, so most of you might be getting married. Most of you are going in a wedding because this is a wedding season as well. And, you know, this is more like some kind of a celebration. There is something you want to celebrate or you want to celebrate with someone very near to you. Okay, so you want peace, you want commitment in your life. So that is what your overall energy is talking about right now. Okay, so there's a lot of fire in your energy. You want the things to be done. So basically fire is you, as we all know, Aries. But yeah, you want to celebrate, you want to be happy. Okay, because the problems might not be, you know, helping you a lot. Whatever is going on in your life that is not helping you, because that is the obstacle. So the obstacle is the Eight of Swords. So this is telling us that there is some kind of entrapment in which you are in. You are feeling trapped, you are feeling that, you know, you are not able to take some responsibility in accordance with this situation. I don't know why that I am really getting that you are in a mode of celebration. Okay, you are in a mode where you want to be happy, but still there is something which you are afraid of. You are like, I cannot celebrate this thing, I cannot tell the world about the situation I'm going through. So there's some kind of fearness which I am talking about. There's some kind of, you know, when there's some kind of a responsibility which is given to us, but we are not able to take that responsibility. That is what you are going through. Your past energies are Renewal, the High Priestess and Ego. So you really came out of a very hard situation. Okay, so that situation actually was so hard. It was like, it was a new transformation. Okay, so I also get an energy where you were you forgive someone. Okay, you were in a place where somebody came to you, a past came back towards you. So this is a strong card for patch up kind of a situation where you this was more like a reconciliation, I would say. You and your past person, you know, there was some sorries and there was some forgiveness, something like that happened, and you got clarity of the situation. Whatever there was in the past, you really tried to understand the exact scenario, and then only you let your ego away, because the third card is the Ego. So yeah, that was the situation. This was pretty hard for you, because at first you never try to understand what exactly is happening, why the things are happening again, why are you receiving, why this person came back to you again. Because there's a strong you know, things of basically that situation where you are getting back with your person again, a past person especially. Okay, And I'm really getting an energy of toxic relationships as well. So you got away from that toxic relationship and that person came back again. Because toxic relationships, when we are into karmic relationships, they never end. They really come back again and again and again. So you were in a cycle somewhere. We are going to clarify it more. In the present energies, we have the Ten of Wands, the Chariot and Seven of Cups. So they are like too much of work. You are really going through too much of stress, too much of heaviness in your heart. What is the present, that is the present situation you are going through. Okay, so this might be with the same person you are dealing with in the past, or this can be somebody new, this can be something else, some other situations other than love. It can be, you know, you're trying to balance your life right now with the past lover or a new lover. There are two people, there are two situations, there are different situations. So this is some kind of heaviness and you want to let that thing go away. You really want to move forward, but you have no choice. You want to balance the things. And actually what I'm getting that yes, there are situations in front of you, but somewhere because of your overall energy, which is very positive, I think universe is trying to help you over here. Like, you know, the universe is trying to give you some ideas, some hints that, okay, do this thing first. Now do that thing first, okay? So this is that situation where you have 10 things to do, but you are yourself, you are trying to do one thing at a time, then next, then third, then fourth, okay? So that is because you are surrounded by a lot of choices. This can be you, this can be a person in your life, this can be a situation in your life which needs a decision. You have a lot of choices in front of you, you have a lot of hurdles in front of you, but which hurdle to take first, that is what you are going through. In the coming future, we have Two of Cups, Seven of Pentacles and Ten of Pentacles. This really seems promising, okay, to me at least, because these are very, very stable cards in the coming future. Because this always tells us, because the Two of Cups always tells us about some kind of falling in love, some kind of a decision making which needs to be done by you. And you know, when we are not ready to give up on something, and this is your energy, totally your energy, because you are really investing your energies and time on something which seems promising, which seems stable. Let's clarify now what exactly the story tells us about you. Okay, so before that, I forgot to check the other energies, the hidden energies. Okay, so we have Five of Pentacles. So this kind of some negative thoughts which are surrounding you, because the obstacle is also Eight of Swords in the middle of the month of July. So there is some kind of when we are in that situation, that negative situation where we are really trying hard to manifest something, but it's not working because we are already negative. And when we are negative and we are manifesting, it doesn't work. Yeah, it doesn't work. Okay, so this is like Nine of Cups. Okay, so you are negative, but somewhere out there, universe is telling you that your wishes are fulfilling. Whatever you are wishing, whatever you have wished, I know that you might be negative because nothing is working for you. Nothing is like, you know, you have been manifesting from months, like 6 months, and your, you know, the people around you, they might be telling you, you know, you will get a person this time, you will get the person that time, but you are not getting anyone. There's nothing, there's no, nothing you are actually able to see in front of you. But the universe is working. Universe is already working. So just, you know, whatever you are investing into, just use your resources wisely. That is what the advice, and that is something which is hidden. That is something basically the universe wants to tell you what is going on, but is hidden from you. Okay, so things are working fine for you, but you do not know that. So a stable beginning is coming. So this is the Ace of Cups, Ace of Pentacles. So yes, this is a very beautiful for those people who are trying to buy a house, a property, in terms of something relation with the new vehicle as well. a new property, house, I already said. And yeah, because I see a house in the picture, so that is why the house is coming up. So for those who are suffering from a bad financial time, or you're not able to collect your resources wisely, so this is the best time. That is, the universe is trying to use your resources wisely so that whatever you are planning for, you can be able to invest on that thing. Okay, so let's see what is there for my Aries, please. Aries. So I want to know about Eight of Swords in the overall energy. Basically, not overall energy, as in of the obstacle energy for my Aries. Tell me more about the Eight of Swords, please. Tell me more about the Eight of Swords energy. Okay, so we have the Two of Swords. We have the Nine of Swords, and we have Queen of Pentacles. Okay, so this looks like things are seeming very tough for you. You know, as I already told you, that you are at a very negative peace of mind, negative state of mind. There is no peace of mind in you. The mental health, you are going through a trauma. You might be going through restlessness. You know, there's some situation in which you are not able to decide where to go, and because of the indecisiveness, you are becoming so self-conscious. You know, lack of self-confidence is there because you are not able to decide for a situation. And when we are not able to decide which way to go, it always tells us to just either stop the situation, either choose one. Okay, but you do not know which one to choose. This can be a person, this can be two people in your life. Okay, so this is more of that situation where you are really confused which way to go, because you have seen a lot, a lot. I think there might be a past person in your life, or a new person. So you are there is like which person to choose, the past person or the new person. Yeah. Okay. So let me clarify this overall energy with the Four of Wands, please. So two people again. So Two of Wands, Six of Cups, yeah, and Six of Swords. So I think, yes, you want to enjoy life, you want to be happy, but with whom to be happy, that is where you are confused. There are two roads in front of you, there are two people in front of you. As I already told you, that there is somebody from the past, and yes, the past is here. You are feeling nostalgic somewhere. There was a toxic relationship in which you were involved in the past. You might be not able to let go of that relationship, and you are ready. And there's somebody who has come in front of you, and he or she is telling you, let's move on. Okay, so you are in that state where you are not even healed yet. And again, one person is just in front of you, and it's like, wow, I do not know what to do. I have a lot of, you know, I have a lot of burden. I have a lot of past regrets. I won't say regrets, it can be anything, it can be some past issues I am facing from that situations, and I'm not ready because I really need to heal myself. I really need to work on myself, then only I'll be able to take some decisions. I'm really confused. Basically, your overall energy, if I talk about the present scenario, you are very confused right now, Aries, whatever is going on in your life. Okay, so let me tell you more about the High Priestess in the past energies. Okay, so we have the Two of Pentacles. A lot of twos are coming in your reading today. So Two of Pentacles, Ten of Swords, and the Sun energies are here. So yeah, you are trying to. There was a situation in your life. Because I am more inclined towards your past energies, because you have gone through a lot of struggles in your past life, past whatever. okay? So you try to make everyone happy, you try to make yourself happy, you try to make yourself confident, but it is like, it seems like you are confident, but still in this decision, in this particular thing, you are not able to decide. Whenever this person comes or whenever the situation comes, it always makes you feel that what is going on. And there was an ending, okay? But with that ending, the person has again come up in your life for a new beginning, I would say. It's like, I'm here again. They are standing in front of you, this toxic relationship person, whosoever this is, that was really toxic. I am really getting strong vibes of that. Okay, so let me clarify the 10 of wands in your present energy. I really feel that you are in a lot of stress right now. You want to move on, you know, you want to balance, you want to prioritize some things, but it's really hard somewhere because it's a lot of things in front of you and you need to prioritize which one to do. I think you have that capability. Some of you are already doing like one thing at a time, but some of you are very confused which one to choose, from which way to go, what to do first. So I have Ace of Wands, ten of Pentacles, and the Ace of Swords. As I already told you that you might be having 10 things in front of you, but you know which way to go. So the cards are also telling that, you know, because these are two aces which has come up in your reading. So you are at a place where you are trying to understand. Like, I really need to remove the fog in front of me. Whatever the people are trying, because there might be some miscommunication, misinformation, I don't know. Something is missing, okay? So there was something, like you might not be told the exact scenario, the exact reality of the situation, and you're trying to find the answers for that, because I'm really getting the investigation word again and again. So that is why I'm saying investigate. You are trying to investigate into something, you are trying to find the answers for something, and until and unless you will not get those answers, like what happened in the past, okay? So if the past person is back again in your life, so you want to know the answers. You are ready with the questions and you want answers that what exactly happened, and that person is not ready for the answer. So until and unless you will not get those answers, you are not going to take any decision in regards with that situation. And to move forward as well is really hard for you at this time. This is why you are going through a lot of, you know, entrapment, which I told you why the mid-month is going through like that. Let's clarify your future energies now. What is this Two of Cups? Who is this? Is this a person? Okay, so I got Two of Cups again for you. Okay, Two of Cups clarified by Two of Cups with the Eight of Wands and the King of Swords. All right. Okay. Either this is a new person or this is the old one. Because there is a lot of forgiveness, because I got two words for you today. One was the investigation word and the other is forgiveness, which I'm really, it's repeating in my mind. And it's like some kind of forgiveness. You are trying to communicate to someone, you want forgiveness, you want an apology from them, and then only you will forgive them. But some person's ego is strong here in the future. You know, this is, I don't feel that this is your energy, Aries. This is more of somebody else, more like a Libra or any other air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. So this is a more of an egoistic energy which is coming up. It's like, I will not say sorry, but I want you. I want to talk to you. Something like that, you know. But one more thing, the challenges which you are facing at this moment, they seems ending. They seems to end, because King of Swords also tells us that, you know, this person is very practical. This person, the emotions are lost for this person. This person does not think emotionally. This person is like, okay, this person gets selfish when it comes to him or her. So this can be you somewhere, because you want to end challenges in your life. You want to communicate with new people. If the old people are not giving you the answers, so it's better to just let these people go and to move on. But I am really getting an energy of you are getting those answers which you are seeking in the present moment. Okay, so you are getting those answers in the future. Somebody is trying to communicate. Somebody wants to talk to you. Somebody is like, has come back again in your life. But yeah, the answers which you are asking, there might be a delay for that. But you will get those answers. For some of you, it can happen that it has already happened. Because many of you always ask me whether these are the present or these are the future, what exactly the scenario is. So sometimes the present energies are the past, the future energies are the present, because it's up to your scenario. There is a proper balance, there is a proper method, like past, present and future. There's a 1, 2, 3. So after 1 only 2 will come, and after 2 only 3 will come. Many of you might already have seen the future energy. Somebody might be going through some past energies only. So yes, so this is how it works. I want to clarify the Seven of Pentacles energy. Tell me more about Seven of Pentacles, please. Seven of Wands, Knight of Wands and the Hanged Man. So whosoever is trying to talk to you in the coming future, you are going to communicate with somebody and you will get those answers which you are seeking for in the present. So they will be like, you know, both of you are very, I think, rigid or stubborn or something like that, that you both are defensive players. You both defend yourself. So if you are trying to defend yourself, the other person also is trying to defend himself or herself, because who will accept? Because I don't see anyone over here accepting any mistake. It's more like, I am right. Okay, so that energy is coming, because there's a lot of ego issues which are coming up here for you. But yes, the communication which you require, which you need, is coming towards you. That is what the future energies hold, because something is stable. Something is becoming stable. Something is becoming more promising, you know. And when we talk it out, then only things become more promising or more comfortable, I would say. Okay. So that is all from my side, my dear Aries. I hope that helps, and we are going to meet you in the next video. Till then, bye.